So 1 week from today, voters will head to the polls in Alabama. This is the RNC has reinstated funding for Roy Moore's campaign, despite serious credible allegations of child molestation against him. The move follows President Trump's endorsement of Moore yesterday. Joining me now is Moore's campaign spokeswoman, Janet Porter. Janet, it is nice to have you on. Thank you for joining us. And let me get right to it.
So Thank you. It's great to be with you. And by the way, congratulations on your unborn child. That's the reason why I came down as a volunteer to speak for Judge Roy Moore, because he'll stand for the rights of babies like yours in the womb, where his opponent will support killing them up until the moment of birth.
Janet, thank you for being with us, and I appreciate the congratulations on our son on the way. Now, let's get right to this. First of all, the call between the president from Air Force One yesterday and Roy Moore, the two spoke after the president endorsed Roy Moore. What can you tell us about that phone call?
Sure. Here's what he had to say. Basically, he knows Judge Roy Moore is a fighter. He's denied all the false, baseless allegations, and he fully supports him. In fact, this is why. He said it in his tweet, that we need his vote on stopping crime, illegal immigration, border wall, military, pro-life, the VA, judges, and the Second Amendment. That's why he says we need Judge Roy Moore, and he's fully behind him. And now, as you know, not only has the RNC backed him, the governor's backed him, the Honorable Congressman Mo Brooks, leaders like Dr. James Dobson, Dr. Ben Carson, we have Governor Sarah Palin, and most importantly, by the way, we also had a 500 pro-life and pro-family leaders that have just signed on to this letter of support to
Janet,
Judge Roy
Moore. Ask you about the
most importantly, the people of Alabama support it.
Let me ask you about the legislation. For example, the Republican tax bill that just made it through the Senate. Would if he were to have been a sitting senator at the time, would Roy Moore have voted for that?
Yes,
he would.
That's
have supported
my understanding.
It. Okay. So let's move on.
He's for tax cuts. He's for secure borders. He's for our Second Amendment. But interestingly, his opponent, when was asked, he can't even deny that he wants to take our guns and religious freedom away.
So, Janet, I want to get through a lot about your candidate. So let's go through some of the allegations against him. First, Lee Korfman, whom we have heard from in her own words, saying at 14 years old, she was a victim of child molestation by Roy Moore. Here she is in her words.
He basically laid out some blankets on the floor of his living room and proceeded to seduce me, I guess you would say. And during the course of that, he removed my clothing. He left the room and came back in wearing his white underwear. And he touched me over my clothing, what was left of it. And he tried to get me to touch him as well.
Do you believe her?
I don't believe her at all, and I'll tell you why. Not only was she sought after by the Washington Post, her own mother doesn't believe elements of her story. The element of the phone call that took place in the bedroom. Mother says there was no phone in her bedroom. The element that she told the Washington Post that her life spiraled out of control after this alleged incident. Well, that's not what her mother said. That's not what the court record said.
So her mother said that there.
Let me respond, if I may.
No phone in the bedroom, which is not the crux of
the
story.
And she also said.
And the Washington Post journalist, the job of journalists is to go ask questions and to follow leads.
They have an agenda.
Might be
questionable.
The job of reporters, because I am one, is to follow leads and ask questions. And that is what the Washington Post did. Lee Korfman did not seek out the Washington Post. She was so hesitant to tell her story. She said that she would not tell it until other women were willing to go on the record. And she said to Savannah Guthrie on NBC, "This has made my life more difficult. I haven't been able to work because of it."
One of the jobs of journalists is to not just take an Academy Award performance at face value. Mm. You need to dig into the facts.
30
and
people
one of the
corroborated
facts in the case,
her story who knew Roy Moore between 1977
actually they did
and
not.
1982.
The
they
collaboration,
did, according
we
to
need
the
to make it clear.
From the Post.
Poppy, we need to make it clear that there's a group of non-accusers that have not accused the judge of any sexual misconduct or anything illegal. But when we're talking about Lee Korfman, even her own mother said that her report to the Washington Post, that her life spiraled out of control after this alleged incident. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, the court records say differently, that she was actually given custody up to her ex, the mother of Lee Korfman gave custody away to her ex-husband because of the severe behavior problems, which got better, not worse, and that was when a year later that custody was returned
to her parents. So Lee Korfman is one of eight women.
Well, let's look at the women, shall we?
Let's look at the women. So
let's
there are
look
four
at, for
women
example, Beverly,
who have accused. There are four women. I ask the questions here, okay? There are four women who have accused the candidate of sexual assault or abuse. There are four more who have said. There are four more who have said that when he was twice their age, they dated him. He dated them when they were teenagers, ranging from age 16 to age 18. Are you comfortable with all of that, and are you saying that all of these women are lying?
If people of legal age share a meal together, that's frankly none of my business. I think what matters in this race is let's look at the accusations. For example, let's look at Beverly Nelson. Everybody knows her yearbook is a forgery, including her attorney, who on your network wouldn't deny that it was a forgery.
That's not
Every
what Gloria Allred said in
false.
Her interview with Allison Camerota in this chair on this show. Allison Camerota pushed her, saying, will you present this to an independent handwriting expert? And she said yes when Roy Moore goes forward and is willing to go under oath about this.
She says when he goes forward before a judiciary committee in the Senate, and guess who sits on that committee? A guy by the name of Al Franken, a guy who's guilty of sexual assault, is supposed to oversee, according to abortion activist Gloria Allred, whether or not this innocent man should serve in the Senate. It's ridiculous. By the way, let's look at Beverly Nelson
for
a moment.
You believe the women who are accusing, you believe the women who have accused Al Franken of these actions,
No, I believe
correct?
Al Franken. He admitted guilt himself.
But do you believe
He's
the women? Did you believe
himself.
The women before Al Franken said, I did these things and I apologize?
I had no opinion until I heard Al Franken
well,
say that I actually admitted.
Well, why did you have no opinion about those women, but you have quite a clear opinion of the women who have accused Senator Roy Moore?
I've done what journalists are supposed to do. Here's why. I've done what journalists are supposed to do. I looked at the facts, and I see, for example, some of these have motivations. For one of the people who spoke out against Judge Moore, well, it just so happened her drug-dealing brother was prosecuted by a guy
about?
By the name of Roy Moore.
What woman are you talking about?
Talking about Faye Gary, who made an accusation against the judge and then went on NBC.
That is not one of the eight women. That is not one of the eight women.
Well, let's look at one of the women. Let's look at Tina Johnson.
Tina Johnson
has an axe to grind against. She has an axe to grind against the judge because he represented the party, her mother, that said that she was an unfit mother, that she had a violent nature, that she was an absentee mother. And so he represented the party that took away custody of her 12-year-old son. These are people who are seeking revenge, much like criminals who are seeking revenge, like the drug dealer that Judge Moore sent to jail just happens to have a brother who's an editor on the Washington Post. If we had real journalism, we'd be asking questions on both sides.
We do. That's exactly what we do every morning here, and I'm glad you're here to answer them. Let's listen to one of your colleagues on this team. The chief strategist for Roy Moore came on this network last night. His name is Dean Young. Here's what he said about the accounts of Roy Moore dating teenage girls. Listen.
If he did date a teenager, he didn't know about it. So I can't tell you how many times I've been on a date and didn't ask a girl how old she was, especially after I asked her mama if I could date them.
Okay, generally important if you have a question about age to know whether someone's underage, but let's put that aside for a moment. That argument does not hold water, Janet, and here's why. Debbie Wesson Gibson, 17 at the time, detailed to the Washington Post in a new piece just yesterday the date she went on with Roy Moore when he was 34, the fact that they kissed. She shows, and there are photographs of the card he gave her for her graduation, what he wrote her when she was graduating from high school, and now your colleague says, well, he didn't know he was dating any teenagers. And you said the same thing to my colleague, Aaron Burnett, that he didn't know he was dating any teenagers. My question is, factually, just yes or no, did Roy Moore date Debbie Wesson Gibson and kiss her when he was 34 and she was 17?
I don't know the answer to that, but I do know that what Debbie Gibson said when she wasn't campaigning for Judge Roy Moore's opponent and posing with pictures she's proud of Hillary Clinton and Joe Biden, what she said is that Judge Roy Moore gave a gift to her fiancé with a congratulatory note. Let me tell you what passes the straight face test. I'm telling you, when I got engaged, no ex-boyfriend gave my husband a gift of any kind, but we did get many gifts from family friends.
You seem to be saying that all of these women are basically Democratic operatives, that they all want Doug Jones to win.
Well, this particular woman, she scrubbed her Facebook page like her Hillary, her hero.
Lee Korfman
scrubbed her emails.
Okay, Lee Korfman, who says she was molested as a child at 14 by Roy Moore, voted
whose mother disputes her
voted for President Trump. And in the past three presidential elections, voted for Republicans. So is your argument here just that these are people with a political vendetta against Roy Moore?
Well, when you've got somebody campaigning for Judge Moore and the most they can come up with is that he's a really nice guy and he gave my fiancé a gift and our families exchanged Christmas cards.
So you're not answering my question. My question was just about Lee Korfman, going back to her, going back to the first allegation of these women against Judge Roy Moore.
This is a woman who's repeatedly voted
for Republican candidates.
Maybe she has, maybe she hasn't. What's lacking in all of this is a cross-examination, is oath-taking, is the evidence examination.
I just asked you if Roy Moore would go under oath and testify before Congress on this. And instead of answering that with yes or no, you said, well, it's Al Franken that leads the committee.
To the demands of Gloria Allred. I don't think he needs to bow
you
the demands
that
of Gloria Allred and sit
citizen.
Under Al Franken
I'm asking
in the
you
Senate committee.
This is an American citizen. Would he go under oath and answer these questions that the American people deserve answers to?
Well, again, what are the questions? The questions, looking at the non-accusers, I think that those questions are completely irrelevant.
Is he guilty of pedophilia and child molestation? I think no matter what your political persuasion
is something that
those are important questions to be asked. So again, I will ask you.
May I respond?
Again, I will ask you, will Roy Moore... Will he be willing to go under oath and testify?
The place to testify under oath, and of course anybody who's being brought under trial would do so, the place to testify under oath is in a court of law.
But as you know, as you well know, these are allegations from the 70s.
If we try people in the court of public opinion, there'd be some lacrosse players in jail right now.
There will be no trial because legally...
Let me tell you about what...
That's not possible. I mean, you know that.
Here's a question that should be asked. If you care about child abuse, you should be talking about the fact that Judge Roy Moore stands for protection, not only of our Second Amendment rights so we can protect ourselves against predators, for the rights of babies like your 8-month baby that you're carrying now. Doug Jones says you can take the life of that baby and we should pay for
it. Let's leave my child out of this.
Well, it's really the children of Alabama that we're talking about, and the Alabamians understand that if we're talking about what's at stake here, we're talking about fake allegations, concocted stories about an innocent man versus real threat of
child abuse, not only in the womb, but also
in the locker room.
Janet, I have respect for you for coming on this show, for taking the time, but I want to make it very clear so everyone understands, you believe that all 8 of these women whom CNN has vetted their stories are lying, that these are, in your words, fake allegations, women that do not know one another.
There are only really
dozens
three,
of people have corroborated their accounts, yes or
May
no.
May I respond?
Yes or no? Do you
believe
of them?
8 of the people are non-accusers that did not accuse Judge Moore of any
sexual
misconduct.
Do you believe these women? Would you like me to name them? All right, I'm going to name them, okay?
I'll name them. Beverly Nelson, who's yearbook, she's the yearbook fraud. She's the yearbook forgery lady. Then you've got Tina Johnson. She's the one that pled guilty to felony fraud and was arrested for theft by deception, which, by the way, is what's happening in Alabama.
So you know
they're trying to steal this election by deception. That's what's happening.
Hold on, Janet. Hold on, Janet. We have them on the screen, and we have very strict vetting policies of people that we will even put on that screen here at CNN. These are the women. You just labeled Beverly Nelson as the only label you gave her is yearbook, that she's lying about a signature in her yearbook. Description.
She lied about more than
that. Here's the description that we give her.
Can I respond?
A woman who
at
16 years old says she was sexually assaulted in Roy Moore's car behind the restaurant where she
worked. And you know what else she said? She said she started working there when she was 15. Turns out you gotta be 16. She said that the dumpsters were behind the restaurant. Turns out they weren't.
So that means she's a liar?
She said it was dark. No,
it was well lit.
Does that
mean she's a liar?
She said it closed. The waitresses who worked at the old Hickory Inn say that she is, and so they should know. They worked
there.
But
you believe them. You believe those waitresses over her. Please answer the first question that I asked, which is, do you believe any of these women, any of these eight women, do you believe any of them?
I believe that Beverly Nelson's own attorney doesn't believe in her. That's why she won't release the yearbook.
We have had Gloria Allred on.
By the way.
And we've asked her those questions. My question to you is, please answer my question. Do you believe the allegations of any of these eight women, Lee Korfman, Tina Johnson, Gina Richardson, Beverly Young Nelson, Wendy Miller, Gloria Thacker Deason, Kelly Thorpe, Debbie Wesson Gibson, do you believe any of them, yes or no?
Your premise is wrong, Poppy. I got to call you on it. Debbie Gibson, who is who's a supporter of his opponent, did not accuse him of any sexual wrongdoing.
Just to be clear,
the others have no evidence whatsoever.
That's a no, correct? You don't believe any of them.
Those who you claim have evidence, the three that have allegations have no evidence. In fact, quite to the contrary, they've all been discredited. But what matters is the people of Alabama believe the judge who has stood for life, for liberty, for honesty, for integrity.
Do you believe any of these women?
Character for 40 years.
Do you believe any of these women?
I believe in the man that I know and trust for the last 20 years, that served in public office for 40 years.
You're not going
to
answer our question.
I'll tell you what it's about. It's all about the Supreme Court of the United States. You realize that this is a winner-take-all race, that the one who wins this race is the one who will decide the Supreme Court for the next 30 or 40 years.
I think there are a lot of really important issues at play here, right? And American people will decide, the voters of Alabama will decide among those important
and
issues.
And if we let the lynch
among those important
media
issues are accusations of pedophilia and child molestation, and I'm asking for an answer. Final question to you. Roy Moore has not been on CNN to answer these questions for himself since February of 2015 when he did an interview with Chris Cuomo, who's sitting right next to me. Why won't he come on and talk to us?
Well, you're not exactly, there's a reason why the people have the phrase fake news, because you're not investigating the false accusations, the credibility problems that are screaming from the forged yearbook to every single thing that's been disputed. And so what I think that he has a right to stand with the people of Alabama and not be subjected to more and more harassment against people who are out to get him, because there's a Senate seat in play that has the Supreme Court in the balance. So I side, instead of with the lynch mob media, instead of the Democrat liberals, instead of the convicted felons that George Soros is now registering to vote, I side with the man who stood for the Ten Commandments, who stood for God, who stood for his principles, has an impeccable character that even Debbie Gibson says is the nicest guy you'd ever want to meet, who never did anything beyond any sexual misconduct or anything illegal in any way.
Janet, I appreciate you taking the time this morning, answering the questions, being with us. We welcome Roy Moore, the candidate, to join us at any time. Thank you very much.